Hi, I'm Kirby Allison, and we love helping the well-dressed take care of their wardrobes. In today's video, I'm going to share with you the 8 secrets to being the best-dressed gentleman in the room. It's really not that hard or that expensive to be really well-dressed. There are, in fact, basic hallmarks of a well-dressed gentleman that anyone can follow. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And remember, if you have any questions or comments during this video, please ask them in the comments section below. Number 1, good hygiene. Looking really good and being a gentleman always starts with pride in yourself. And that always begins with one's personal hygiene. Clean, clipped fingernails don't have to be manicured, but do always have to be clean. Scrub your fingernails if you have dirt or grease underneath them or any shoe polish. There's nothing wrong with the working man, but you cannot go out with grease under your fingernails. You absolutely can't do it. If you shave, make sure you're freshly shaven. And if you have any type of facial hair, make sure it's well trimmed. This also extends, of course, to your nose and your ears. Of course, always shower before getting dressed so that you start your day out fresh and do not soil your clean clothes. Your teeth must be brushed, which will also freshen your breath. If you find that you perspire heavily or have a strong natural body odor, then use a deodorant. I prefer the natural salt-based deodorants, which actually dry out the sweat glands, but you can also use a deodorant with a matching fragrance to your favorite cologne. Once your personal cleanliness is taken care of, you can focus on your personal ensemble for the day. Number 2, clean, unstained, well-mended clothes. Your clothes don't have to be new or expensive, but they just can't be ripped, stained, or threadbare. You also don't have to wear a new, freshly laundered shirt every day, but it does have to be clean and pressed. But if it stinks or has any visible stains, wear a fresh one. Number 3, well pressed. Now that your clothes are clean, they also need to be well pressed. This means a pair of trousers that have a crisp trouser crease and a shirt that is freshly pressed. Having your wardrobe properly pressed just makes you look crisp and together. It's important to avoid that rumpled, wrinkled, you slept in your clothes look. It doesn't make you look organized, trustworthy, or powerful. Just a simple iron, an ironing board, and a spray bottle is really all you need to keep your clothes pressed and looking crisp. You don't have to send everything off to the dry cleaning, to the dry cleaners and spend a fortune with dry cleaning. It's just a matter of taking the time to press your clothes to make sure they look good. Number 4, properly fitting. Your dress shirt, jacket, and trousers need to fit properly. And always better a little loose than a little tight. It always looks bad if your clothes are too tight or too small. But if your clothes are just a little large, they can have their own look. Just like with Anderson and Shepherd, their jackets are always cut to be slightly roomy, but they're never too tight. A collar that is too small is equally bad as a collar that is too large. You don't want to look like a child in your father's shirt, nor do you want to be unable to button your shirt collar. The truth is that your dress shirts should not be uncomfortable when they are buttoned and you are wearing a tie. You should be able to place one or two fingers into your shirt collar and have it not be uncomfortable. Generally speaking, it's also very important to have collar stays to control your collar and to keep this look clean. Now, there are exceptions to that, but they're very deliberate, like with a button-down shirt collar, or if you're wearing a Cooper collar shirt with no tie. And the same goes for trousers. Trousers should extend all the way to the ankle without being too baggy. I prefer a slight break. Pleats are important also because they allow for necessary allowance around the hips and prevent uncomfortable pulling when you sit or stand and whenever you place items in your pockets. Pleats also aid in the reduction of wrinkling at the hips when you sit down. And suspenders with trousers cut slightly large at the waist, larger than what you would have on tabbed trousers, take comfort to a whole new level, but I'll save this for another video. If you're not comfortable in a suit, it doesn't fit. I'm telling you, the most comfortable clothing a man can wear is a dress ensemble. A properly fitting wool suit where the fabric is matched to the climate, a dress shirt whose collar fits properly, and a tie is absolutely the most comfortable clothing a man can wear. If it isn't, it doesn't fit. That's a fact. Number 5, well-polished dress shoes. Well-polished shoes with unfrayed laces absolutely make a difference in being well-dressed. This has been proven study after study. Both men and women notice the condition of a man's shoes right away. Not only will a well-polished pair of shoes make you look better, but they'll also make your shoes last longer. A little bit of effort, our high quality shoe polish, and our Hanger Project High Shine Chamois is all you need to make your shoes look great. Of course, it's also very important that your heels aren't worn down and you don't have any holes in the sole of your shoes. And for that, we have our Kirby Allison Recrafting Program. Of course, we have an extensive library of shoe care tutorials to help you learn how to properly care for and polish your shoes, but it should be said that shoe care is not complicated. Shoelaces have a disproportionate effect on the look of a pair of shoes. Worn, frayed, or broken shoelaces will make even the best shoes that are highly polished look terrible. Taking a little bit of extra time to switch out your shoelaces whenever you're polishing them with a new, fresh pair really goes a long way in just helping make your shoes look good. Of course, our Kirby Allison Sovereign Grade shoelaces are the finest made anywhere, and we have a complete collection in several different lengths, colors, and styles to ensure that you can find a perfect match for your dress shoes. Number 6, pocket squares. You can never go wrong with a white pocket square. However, matching your pocket square to your ensemble in a neutral or complementary color is always a good idea. However, you never want to exactly match your pocket square to your tie with the same silk. A pocket square is just a subtle style detail that just helps make you look well-dressed. Number 7, a tie tied to the proper length and with the proper dimple. Most ties look best with a nice dimple. The dimple is simply the indentation that comes out of the middle of the tie as it exits the tie knot. This isn't difficult to achieve, but does take a few tricks and a little bit of practice to get it perfectly. Also, the length of your tie is very important. The length of a tie should always extend slightly above the top of the waistband. It shouldn't be too short, nor should it be too long. Now, you might have to adjust where the back blade ends in order to reach that point, but it's always more important to have the front tip of the blade be the proper length than worrying too much about the back. Depending on how tall you are and your neck size, your blade may be really short, or the back blade may extend beyond your front blade slightly. That's perfectly okay. The most important thing to organize around is making sure that the tip of your front blade is just right at the top of your trouser. Number 8, a nice fragrance. It's always nice to top off a beautiful ensemble with a little bit of a nice cologne so that you smell as good as you look. It doesn't have to be an expensive fragrance, it just has to smell good. Just be careful to not use too much so that it's not overpowering. The only way you can go wrong with a fragrance is if you use way too much. For a large part of the day, people will be put off because you smell way too strong. But in general, some cologne is always a good idea. If you're preparing for anything important, you start by taking care of yourself. You take a nice hot shower, you shave, you trim your nose and ears and eyebrows if necessary, you put on a little cologne, shine your shoes, press any garments that need to be touched up, and then dress well. This doesn't have to be difficult, time-consuming, or expensive. Instead, it can be a ritual you enjoy and to which you look forward. It is really not that expensive and not that difficult to be the best dressed, most comfortable guy in the room. If you're clean and your clothes fit and are pressed, with just a little bit of effort, you can really be that guy. If you have to make a choice, it is always better to be slightly overdressed than underdressed. Everyone will have a higher opinion of you and you'll be surprised how people treat you. You will always, always be treated better. If you doubt this, just do me a favor and give it a try, I promise you. If you follow these rules, perfect strangers will treat you with a higher regard. In today's video, I'm wearing the black jacket for my stroller as an odd jacket. This was made in London by Anthony Hewitt, who actually did my entire stroller ensemble. I have my white Charvet shirt with a white Simonuk Godard pocket square, and I'm wearing one of my favorite ties, our Kirby Allison Sovereign Grade tie that we have here at the Hanger Project. What I especially love about these ties is the beautiful dimple that I'm able to get with them. I'm wearing my light gray bespoke Chris Despis trousers with a single reverse pleat and with tabs, so I don't wear these with belts. They have a slight break. I'm also wearing my bespoke George Cleverly seamless hole cut imitation semi-brogue shoes. These are an incredibly special pair of shoes. It's made from a single piece of leather. There's no seam, not on the sides, not on the back. The pattern you see is actually punched into the leather with broguing, but despite looking like a semi-brogue, it's actually a single piece of leather, an incredibly unique and special shoe, and one that you can really only get bespoke. And then I'm wearing my favorite pair of Kirby Allison Sovereign Grade gray small dot melange dress socks. If you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up and please subscribe to our channel and turn on your notifications by clicking the bell to the right of the subscribe button so that you can learn whenever we release new videos. If you have any questions or comments about anything we discussed on this video, please ask them in the comments section below. And of course, please visit hangerproject.com, where we have the largest, most comprehensive collection of luxury garment care and shoe care accessories in the world, as well as many other incredible products for the well-dressed. And while you are there, subscribe to our newsletter to receive notifications of new product launches, promotions, as well as a weekly digest of all the videos we publish here on our YouTube channel. I'm Kirby Allison, and thanks for joining me for this video on the 8 secrets of how to be the most well-dressed gentleman in the room.